In this video, you'll see how you can control data replication for source servers with AWS Application Migration Service, or AWS MGN. With this solution, you can stop, start, pause, and resume data replication as needed. Additionally, you can install the AWS Replication Agent on your source servers without automatically starting data replication. We'll begin by navigating to the AWS Application Migration Service console, where we can manage data replication for our source servers. AWS MGN is a new and improved migration service that can be used to replicate servers from their source locations to AWS. For each source server we migrate, we can use AWS MGN for a free period of 90 days. Let's open the details for the second source server. We can use the replication dropdown to stop data replication for this source server. Typically, replication is stopped when a server migration needs to be put on hold for a long period of time. Let's return to the active source servers page. We can also perform replication actions from here for a single source server or for multiple source servers at once. In this example, we'll stop data replication for the second source server. While replication is stopped, this source server will not incur charges for replication, and time will not be counted towards the 90-day free replication period. Additionally, existing EBS snapshots, EBS volumes, and replication servers will be deleted. However, the source server will remain in the active source servers list, its configuration data will be retained, and the AWS replication agent will remain installed. The source server's migration lifecycle status is not ready. The data replication status is stopped, and the next step is to start data replication. Now let's restart data replication for this source server. The source server has begun the initial sync to create the replicated volumes and launch the replication server. Let's open the server details to view the replication initiation steps. Let's return to the list of active source servers. We can also pause data replication for a short period of time to conserve data-centered bandwidth or resolve project blockers. Let's pause replication for the second source server. Pausing the replication won't stop billing, delete existing snapshots, or delete EBS volumes. Additionally, replication servers won't be terminated, and the agent won't be uninstalled from the source server. Notice that the source server remains in the list of active source servers. Its migration lifecycle status is not ready, and the next step is to resume data replication. Now let's resume data replication. The AWS replication agent will now perform a rescan. Let's navigate to the server details to view the rescan progress. Let's return to the list of active source servers. The AWS replication agent must be installed on each source server that is added to AWS Application Migration Service. By default, replication is enabled when the agent is installed. However, AWS MGN now provides the option to install the agent without starting replication immediately. Let's open a command line interface to see how. We'll run a command to install the AWS replication agent on our source server and add the no replication tag to prevent the source server from replicating immediately. The agent has been installed. Let's return to the AWS MGN console. The source server is now active and the data replication has not started. We can start replicating the data on this source server using the same steps as earlier. You've just seen how to control data replication for source servers with AWS Application Migration Service. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.